Welcome to Unleash, a Tricom podcast that delves into topics that impact your business, from leadership, teamwork, and personal development. All are essential components of any successful organization. Our goal is to provide valuable insight, inspire, and motivate individuals for personal and professional growth, while promoting self-reflection and a growth mindset by sharing practical tools and resources. We are back exploring attitudes and the influence and impact they have on our lives and our work environment. How we interact with others, attitude shapes our experiences and determines the outcomes we achieve. Back joining me today is on this subject matter is Amanda Jadro, Tricom's Director of Credit. Hello, Amanda.
Hi, Julianne.
Thanks for joining me again.
Thanks for having me back.
We're back on attitudes.
We are.
It's great. So, we both read John Maxwell's book, Attitude 101. You have it with you. Mine's all marked up with flags and all different highlights and all that. So today we're going to talk about developing a great attitude, correct?
That's right.
Excellent. I'll let you start. What should we start with first on developing a great attitude?
I think the most important thing to start with is having a willingness to change. Mm-hmm. An attitude is something that changes depending on the circumstance and experiences that you're having, and being willing to change that attitude to make sure that it's fitting the circumstance and the situation correctly.
Definitely. We were having this debate last night, my husband and I, because I was talking about, we were talking about this podcast, and I said to him, it's really about someone's awareness, self-awareness,
right,
and then the willingness to change. And he's like, no, everybody can change their attitude. I'm like, no. You really need to have awareness, and you have to have be willing to change.
Mm-hmm.
If you're not willing to change, you're always going to be, you're never going to improve that attitude, right?
Yeah, and I think attitude stems back to that early childhood and those experiences that you have, those belief systems that you have and
right,
that you grow up with. And it's kind of your foundation. So you have new experiences throughout life that continue to change that. But over time, people very easily fall back or revert back to what's just comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
And it's something that you have to continuously work on.
Right.
And it's something that can be difficult to change because it might be different than your just kind of general personality and traits.
Right. I think you hit a key component there. You said the key words. You have to continuously work on it. You have to continuously be either improving on yourself by reading, by going to, I think, like sessions, something.
Mm-hmm.
Improvement doesn't come by just, oh, well, I go to work every day and I go home every day. I think you have to be, there's a lot of awareness and focus on, I want to improve myself. So I'm going to, for me at least, it is, mm-hmm, I'm going to read about attitudes. I'm going to read about leadership. I'm going to go to a leadership seminar. I'm going to do this because for me, it's always improving. I always want to do better and be better. And so it's a continual process.
It is. And it's something that's really important to kind of have that love of that lifelong learning.
Mm-hmm.
I think that does help shape your attitude. It reframes your mindset, which is really where your attitude comes from.
Mm-hmm.
It's your thoughts. What are you thinking about and how are you perceiving that? That's really affecting what's happening with your attitude right now today.
Right. So we're talking about positive thinking. That
yep,
has a lot to do with it.
Yep.
Practice refraining from negative thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
Do you look at things, how do you look at things objectively, positive or not? We talked about that in a couple of episodes. Like when you look at opportunities or are they problems?
Right.
And that really is positive thinking.
It is.
And it's, again, half glass half full or half empty. It's all about positive thinking.
It is.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
So I try to focus on a solution rather than a problem. And we do that here at Tricom. We always say, okay, what's the opportunity that we have in front of us?
Yeah.
Not what is the problem, right?
Absolutely. And asking other people, get opinions from other people.
Mm-hmm.
It does help to see the way somebody else might view something because then maybe it's something that you're just taking too personally. And
mm-hmm,
sometimes other people will help kind of check that for you.
Right. John talks about it in the book that the other way to develop a healthy attitude, a positive attitude, is really about developing an attitude of gratitude.
Yes.
And I really believe in that, is to be grateful not only for what you have, but for the things that the people around you. And it's something that we talked about yet in our last episode is listing all the, in the morning, sitting down and putting things that I'm grateful for, and I talk about my staff and the clients and my job and stuff like that, and really setting that mindset of having gratitude and being grateful.
It's a good way to start your day.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You can only create positive things from there when that's the way you've started your morning.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you start with a bad day and it feels like it carries with you throughout the day, unless you're willing to, you have that self-awareness and make that change. But starting your day off certainly gets you going in that direction right off.
Yeah.
Right out the door there.
I strongly recommend that 5-minute journal. I'm not a journal person. I cannot journal every day, but the 5-minute journal literally takes you 5 minutes. Mm-hmm. And you write down, what are you grateful for? It's like 3 sections, 3 different questions. And then at night, it takes you like 2 minutes to answer 2 questions. And I really love that journal book. It's great. So I highly recommend the 5-minute journal. So what was the other items that John talked about in the book? Do you remember?
Oh, yes. Some of the things that I have here, that everyone can have a positive life and joy filled with potential here. Just have to elevate your present attitude. That you should realize that faith is stronger than fear, and that you should have a purpose. I think those 3 things really change your attitude and the way that you're viewing things, and fills you with this potential, this that you can do anything, that you choose the joy based on the things that are happening. Personal things do not really provide any type of joy for anyone. The joy comes from within.
Right. The other thing he said, and I've tried to do, is learn from the setbacks in your life. Learn from all the storms in your life. As you know, I went through a really bad storm in my life a few years ago, and that was really hard because it's like everybody could see. I was going through a divorce and everybody could see, and I fell off this pedestal, and that was really difficult. And then I decided that I could be a victim, or I could be somebody that says, okay, I'm going to learn from this and be a better person, and I'm going to help others who are going through this ever. And I'm going to learn from the mistakes I made and be a stronger, better person. And so, yeah, that's the whole thing. You just have to learn from your setbacks. And so what I try to do is reflect back on those times that I've gone through storms and write down. And that's the only time I do journal, is I go back and go, okay, here, in that storm, what could I learn that was a positive thing from that storm?
Right.
And then go forward with it. And I think that's really helped me be a more positive person in life.
Absolutely. And, to add on to that, I would say just, live one day at a time when you're going through difficult things. Focus on what you can control today. And not worry too much about what's happened in the past or what could happen in the future, because sometimes that's really overwhelming and it changes your attitude.
Right, right. That's great. Well, I'm wondering, is this time to bring in our special guest today?
Yes, I'm very excited about our special guest.
Right, we talked about it in our last podcast. So we have a brand new employee. Well, I should say brand new. She's been with us about 4 months, I would say. And we love her. She's been a great asset to the company, not only with her skill set, but her attitude. And she really is Attitude 101. She should write a book on Attitude 101, because she comes in, as we said last podcast, she is one of 2 people that comes in every day with this big, great smile on her face. She uplifts the whole department. Department people love her. The staff in general love her. I want to talk to her about that. I also want to talk about what she does uniquely with her customers. So Amanda and I are going to ask her a few questions. So I'm going to slide over, share my mic with her, but I'm going to introduce Jennie Revord with Tricom. Hi, Jennie.
Hi, Jennie. How are you guys?
Good.
I'm crying. That was a great introduction.
Yeah, I'm going to give you the mic.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
That's okay.
First time.
That's okay. We're glad you're here.
Thank you for having me.
Well, thank you for coming. We put you on the spot today and said, would you join us?
I know.
So why is it? I mean, how do you do it every day? You have this smile, this energy every day you come to work.
Well, it's a conscious choice. It's not, I just don't do it. I have to, tell myself, okay, you can either have a bad day or you can have a good day. And sometimes, if you have a bad day, I actually read this in one of my children's books when we were reading. It was something about being mad, and this little boy just counted to 10. So if you're having a bad day, sometimes you just need to sit back, count to 10, and proceed on with your day. Because then a lot of times it just allows you to breathe, get rid of negative energy, and focus on something else and keep going.
Wow. You bring in so much energy to the team too. You have fun with your team.
I do. I'm here most of my day, so mm-hmm. why not? I enjoy making people smile. I enjoy lifting people up. I enjoy laughing myself. So, I really feel like I find friends along the way, like everywhere I go. Mm-hmm. And that's important to me. Relationships and just making people feel good makes me feel good. So mm-hmm. it's a two-way street.
Well, I have to tell you, I took two of your coworkers out to lunch a couple of weeks ago to the gentleman, and they're like, they love Jennie. I'm like, so how's it in your department? What do you like about your department? They're like, we love Jennie. Jennie just brings so much energy to the department. She makes us laugh. We just love having her in the department. So,
well, I come in, I share like real life stories. You know, I think people are not as open as I am, mm-hmm. but I think it can be beneficial sometimes to be open, because somebody might be going through something similar to you, but they don't want to talk about it. And if my loudness, just they're like, oh, she's going through it too. Absolutely. You know, and we can get through it. And I've always felt like that. You know, I'm open about a lot of things in my life. And people have told me, you know, thank you. I didn't even know you went through that too. Mm-hmm. I'm like, absolutely. I do come off like I'm confident and, you know, but I have my days. I mm-hmm. absolutely have my days. So I think it's important just to share and just be mindful.
Very cool.
Well, it's a bonding experience.
It totally is.
Bond the team together. You know, when you're sharing, then they start to share because you've opened up. It gives them the permission that they think that they can do it too.
Absolutely.
So it helps you guys bond as a team really well.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah. It's a great way to do that.
It is. I mean, and you know, it's important, I think, sometimes to know, you don't have to know everyone's life story, but we all go through things, mm-hmm. and it's important to feel like supported at home, at work. I mean, we're here all week. All day. So, I mean, to have support here, which we totally do, I feel like I have friends.
Sometimes we see each other more than we see our spouses.
I know.
Right?
I mean, that's not always a bad thing. Right?
I won't let your spouse know.
No, don't give them the link to this.
So, tell us, there is something that you do every day with your clients. It's amazing because you've really taught the staff. Our own staff about this.
Yeah. Well, I send positive quotes out on Monday and Tuesday. I send a daily report to them, and it's the beginning of the week. Some of us are a little bit sluggish, and we're like, oh, it's Monday again. The weekend always goes by way too fast. And I always send some type of positive quote for the week. And a lot of times it's nothing, you know, in particular, but it's something that'll grab my attention mm-hmm. and make me feel a certain way. And I think it's important because, especially at the beginning of the week, we may not have gotten everything done that we need to do over the weekend. You might be feeling, not motivated. And I think it's important. All you need to do sometimes is see something, and your attitude can change like that. And just mm-hmm. something positive, it can just flip the script for the day. So I send that on Mondays and Tuesdays to all my clients, and they've really seemed to like them. They like them, and I've gotten responses back. And it's not just for them. It's for me, too, because I'm like, let's go get the week. You know, let's do it. And so it's important.
We have had positive responses from clients on that and staff.
Yeah.
Yeah, you've impacted a lot of people.
I do send it to staff, too,
yes,
sometimes.
Yes, you do. Yes, you have.
I mean, it's like the small things like that that really count. Like, I mean, I'll see something and I'll be like, all right, no, yeah, let's do it. Because you might be going down the wrong path, and then all of a sudden that little positivity floats in and you can be like, okay, let's change it up.
It's great.
Yeah.
It's great.
I enjoy it.
Yeah, it's very uplifting.
It is.
And it's, you know, exciting. I can't wait to open your email and see what the quote of the day is.
Right.
Be.
I know.
So that's fun for me as well.
Yeah, you got one today, right?
I did, and I loved it, by the way.
Yeah. I didn't get one yet, but I got a treat. She sweetened me up yesterday for a deal yesterday, and it won, so it was
like,
good.
Pick me.
And she put a piece of chocolate candy, which I love, so she knew that. Dark chocolate, too, so see?
Well, I had a little insight
info. Oh. Okay. Okay, good job. Very good.
What's your sources?
I do my research.
Yes. So is there anything else that you feel like you want to share with the audience on attitude, on, you know, that you do, or anything that you feel like you've learned?
Well, I think just overall, it's important to just have a good mindset. Every day we're changing. So you said it before, you have to be able to change. I think reading a room is very important. That is a skill. I mean, not all of us have, I guess, but to just look around, look at people's faces, look at people's behavior, because that can teach you a lot about, you know, proceeding in. I mean, like talking about, I don't know, different subjects, but I think reading people is a very underrated thing, you know, and it's important. If I see someone having a bad day, maybe I'll go, you know, do a little extra, you know, hello or something, but I think that's really important. Just human connections, again, they've been lost for so long, for, you know, and I just think it's like really important to just be human again and know that everyone is going through something, and if you can make someone smile, you have a good smile at the end of it. The day when you go home. So
wow, that's so good, Drew. Excellent. That was a great end way to end our podcast today.
I feel like
anything
I'm crying.
Else?
Oh. I love talking about it.
That's okay. It's a good thing.
That's
a great thing.
It's right? Passion
right
there.
Right.
That's what happens.
Yes.
Right. Anything else? Do you have anything?
No. You know, some of the things that they covered quick in the book here that I thought was interesting was just, you know, changing your thought pattern and your vocabulary, changing, you know, I can't to I can, or, you know, impossible to possible, just changing up some of the ways that you even talk to yourself, the way you talk to other people. I think those are things that are really important to help just create that positive energy.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's funny because I was doing I was working with a group last week of mentees, I guess how you call it. I was doing a presentation, and the one gentleman said to me, he goes, you're a fighter. You're just a really fighter. And I said, no, I guess I am, but it's my attitude. I said, I always am. I can do this. Mm-hmm. Inside, I know I have this fear or I'm scared, but outside, I'm like, no, I can do it. I have a mindset that I can do it. And I've always been challenging myself, pushing myself. When I'm running, I'm pushing myself. You and I have talked about that. We're like, no, we can do another half mile. We can do another mile.
Yep.
And we just keep going because we challenge ourselves. And that's, so it is, I guess, a fighter mentality.
Yep.
But it's our mindset. It really is.
Mm-hmm.
So
there's a song that you should listen to while running. Then I used to listen to it when I was a runner. But it was, I'm a survivor. I'm not going to give up. You know, it just.
Is that the Carrie Underwood one?
No, it's Destiny's Child.
Yeah.
But it's like an old one.
Yeah.
And it was like, I'm a survivor.
Yeah.
I used to play that when I would work out. And I'm like, that's right. You're not
going
to give up.
Yeah.
And it was just.
Keep going, right?
Hey, I got to put that in my thing. I need that.
Yeah.
I need that. I need that in a couple of weeks, in a couple of months when I do Tough Mudder. And I'll need that really bad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do it. Yeah.
See, this old lady needs that.
Yeah.
So.
It'll work. I promise.
Good. Well, I think we're going to wrap that up. This is, I'd like to thank Amanda and Jennie for joining me today on our third and final podcast on the Attitude Series. And it was a great run. I enjoyed it a lot.
So
thank you
I.
for joining us
hey,
at the last
thank
minute.
Thank you for having me.
Yes,
wow.
Our special guest today.
Yes. It
I
was fun.
That.
It was fun. Join us on our next episode as we explore leadership. Thank you again for listening, and don't miss our next podcast.